Strawberries, kiwi fruit, cherries. Everyone relies on fruit to stay healthy, but destructive pests and diseases often cause them to go bad. One example is the spotted-winged Drosophila fruit fly, Drosophila suzuki, characterized by two black spots on the wings of males. These insects cause significant damage to fruit production worldwide and create an economical burden for farmers as a result. Eradication has proved impossible, so how do you stop them? Broad-spectrum pesticides are one option, but pesticides come with potential downsides. They may have an adverse impact upon the environment, and they may also affect human health. Stopping fruit flies is therefore much easier said than done, and they're not the only problem. Bacterial pathogens also pose a substantial threat to the fruit industry, as there are no effective means for disease control. So what can be done? How do you stop the unstoppable? Introducing the Dropsa Project. Coordinated by Dr. Neil Audsley at Fera, the Dropsa Project's aims were to develop effective, innovative, practical and integrated solutions for the control of pests and diseases. Throughout the four-year EU-funded project, Fera and 25 partners throughout Europe, Asia, New Zealand and North America have examined several potential chemical, biological, cultural and novel pest and disease control strategies. At Fera, Dr. Audsley and colleagues have tested the efficacy of commercial insecticides, as well as biological control using entomopathogenic fungi, and are currently developing novel compounds. Entomopathogenic fungi infect adult flies to reduce fruit fly populations and could provide a useful tool in an integrated pest management strategy. Looking into Drosophila suzuki's physiology, Dr. Audsley and his team have also targeted the two key components responsible for fruit flies' reproduction and development: neuropeptide hormones and their associated G-protein-coupled receptors. Disrupting the normal function of these hormones and receptors resulted in an inappropriate physiological response that caused death, thus reducing fruit fly populations. The main aim was to specifically target receptors in fruit flies without killing off beneficial invertebrates. The Dropsa Project has identified alternative methods to control fruit fly and bacterial pathogen populations. As a result, it may now be possible through integrated pest management to reduce the environmental impact of commercial insecticides and manage pesticide resistance. But that's not all. The Dropsa Project has also provided food for thought for future pest control research and will help prevent further damage to global fruit production.